Hello, TMI. This is Father Scott Brown coming to you from TMI, from our beautiful campus. Behind me is the football field where next week we will celebrate the class of 2020 for their commencement ceremonies, their graduation, and I'm so excited to see them and to welcome them and their families to campus for this exciting day. 2 weeks ago, I came to you with an update for reopening school. That was on June the 5th, and at that time, I committed to giving you every two-week updates on where we are as we prepare to come back to campus on August 20th. Today is my next update for you. I want to remind you that coming back to campus is our priority. We are planning to be here August 20th, and we are planning to stay on campus the entire semester. But in order to do that, we have to be safe. And I want to update you on a few of the things that we're doing to make sure that we can come back to campus safely. One of the things I want to make you aware of, TMI, is that we sent out a survey, and almost 300 individuals completed that survey. We asked you a variety of questions about your concerns about coming back to campus. One thing that is crystal clear to all of us on this campus is that 92% of our families said that if COVID-19 conditions remain as they are today, you want your students back on campus. 92% of you said, we want our students on campus August 20th if conditions remain the same. I can tell you that as a parent and as the head of school, I wholeheartedly agree with that. I want our students back. I want my own children back. I want us back on campus on August the 20th, and we all really, really agree on that. The majority of us also agree on things like hand sanitizers and protocols for checking fevers and safety checks at the front welcome center. We agree on a lot of things about coming back to campus. Masks, on the other hand, we don't always all agree about. I'm filming this on Wednesday, but it's coming to you on Friday. I believe that today, Judge Nelson Wolf will sign an order requiring masks for all businesses, which would include us. I believe that's happening today. You'll know more than I will because this video is coming to you after this news is breaking. But let me just say this. TMI will require masks, not just because there's likely going to be an order around it, but because the science behind the virus is crystal clear that wearing a mask slows down the spread of the virus. Being on campus is priority number one. And if in order to be on campus, we have to wear masks, then we're wearing masks. And I'm telling you this now because there are passionate views on both sides of the mask conversation. What's crystal clear is we're wearing them. The survey also was pretty clear about a few other things that are on your mind. One of those is the economic impact around COVID-19. You may have experienced this economic impact in your own family. And I can tell you that it's affected TMI as well. We have a lot to glean from your survey, from the responses that you gave. Give us some time. The survey just closes today, Wednesday. Again, I'm filming this on Wednesday. The survey just closes today, and then we'll take that survey, take that feedback, and then tell you what we've learned about it. But my initial takeaway from your survey is that the things that you're tracking, we're tracking. The things that you're questioning, we're following. The things that you're suggesting, we've already thought about. So nothing was new to us. That's good news to me because we're tracking the things that you are tracking. I want to talk finances for a little bit. Earlier this week, you received an email from the business office telling you that we're shifting from fax to school admin for the billing software, and that's a great change for us. So be on the lookout for emails from school admin about how to settle up with the business office on your expenses. But speaking of finances, I want to again recognize the financial impact that COVID-19 has had on our economy, including you possibly and TMI. As we prepare for next school year, I want to make sure that you understand that Episcopal schools are nonprofit schools. And as such, our budgets are positioned as break-even budgets. So our expenses for next year are set. And a large majority of those expenses go directly to personnel costs. So we cannot continue to provide academic growth and student success without our amazing faculty and staff. So we're committed to supporting them. We're committed to compensating them. And regardless of whether or not we have remote instruction or on-campus instruction, those costs remain. In addition to personnel costs, we have utilities and vehicles to pay and a number of fixed costs. Our maintenance and facilities teams still show up on campus and keep this place beautiful, whether our students are here or not. So our expenses are set. While there will be a minimal savings in areas such as food or travel, there are new increased expenses around things like sanitation and safety. So I want you to know that I understand the questions you ask about our school finances, which is why I invite any of you to reach out to me and have a conversation. TMI is not wasteful. We are committed to good stewardship of our financial resources, and I'm happy to talk to you about those decisions if you are interested. As many of you know, I'm a parent at TMI as well. My sons are entering 9th and 12th grade, but I also recognize that I can't appeal to you as a TMI fellow parent because I am admittedly a biased TMI employee. So I want to also remind you that I have a daughter who's at a different Episcopal independent school in town. She's a fourth grader now. And I got to tell you, I love my daughter's school. I receive updates from their administration regularly. I'll admit some of those updates I agree with. Some of them leave me scratching my head. Some of the updates from her school are crystal clear. Some are still quite vague. Like TMI, there's a lot in my daughter's school that is still very unknown. Like TMI, my daughter's school doesn't know exactly what August looks like. All of my questions about her school experience next year have not been answered as of today. However, I continue to support my daughter's school. I continue to support it financially and emotionally. I do so because I believe in the things that her school believes in. And I know that paying my daughter's tuition, regardless of what next year looks like, allows her school to keep their amazing faculty, to keep paying the expenses that don't go away, whether they're on campus or not. The bottom line is I trust the leadership of her school, and I value the things that her school values. I believe in her school's mission. I've seen the results of the graduates from her school. I know how prepared her classmates who have graduated from her school are for TMI and for the world. So because of all that, I'm in. I support her school. Am I nervous? You bet I am. Am I anxious? Sure. Am I curious? Yes, but I'm in. Would I like a discount on my tuition that I pay for her school? It would be nice. I bet you'd like one too. But I understand the sacrifices that independent schools make, like hers, like ours, in order to make our expenses work. And I understand that cutting expenses and refunding part of the tuition to families would require us to cut the very things that you love and value most about our community, including our amazing teachers and our amazing coaches and our extracurricular programs and our commitment to the heart of each student. So in short, it's not worth it to me. And I bet it's not worth it to you either. Let me shift away from finances and talk about academics. And as we prepare for the opening on August 20th, I want to remind you about our academic response team. This team consists of educators and physicians who know our school well. They understand the science behind COVID-19, and they're committed to keeping our entire community safe. I trust this team. They're developing guidelines and practices and procedures and schedules and policies that work for TMI. And I encourage you to trust them as well. While we're committed to having school on campus as much as possible, this team is working on a variety of schedules for the varying scenarios that we may face throughout the year, including a daily schedule that would take into account how we manage health and safety requirements while keeping the day as normal as possible. We already know that some things like chapel or lunch will look very differently. But we're confident that for most of our academic day, we can minimize the disruptions. If, and I repeat, if we're required to stay home and go to a fully online school day, along with every other school in our area, then I'm telling you, the academic response team has created schedules that will combine regularly scheduled classes with teachers that will meet with your students multiple times per week and allow extra time available for tutorial and help sessions. As much as we do not want to go to remote instruction, if we do, it will be very different than the way you encountered it last spring. It will look much more like a normal school day. This week, the academic response team continued working on maximizing spaces all around this beautiful campus, including thinking innovatively about how we can reuse some spaces. They measured every room, and we're now calculating how many students we can safely put in a room in order to practice social distancing. That number, which we will have very soon, will determine a lot more decisions around the corner. In closing, I want to remind you that I'll have another update for you in 2 weeks, just before the July 4th weekend. I'm confident that the closer we get to August 20th, the more concrete and practical updates I'll be able to give you. For now, if you're wanting to know exactly what our plans are for August 20th, let me recap as clear as I can. We're coming back to school August 20th. We're practicing social distancing. We're wearing masks. We'll wash hands often. We'll require health screenings. And we'll be prepared for whatever curveball comes our way. Coming back to school in August is going to happen, but it's going to require awareness and discipline and teamwork, but it's going to happen. TMI, I love you. I pray for you. I pray that your families are healthy and happy and safe, and I look forward to seeing you soon. My next academic update will be in 2 weeks. Until then, take care and God bless.